Welcome to the channel. Thank you guys for joining me. Happy July. And also happy full moon in Capricorn. So I have my notes of what I want to talk about. So I'm not going to talk too much about the different houses and so on. And tomorrow I'll film the reading for each signs, right? But today I wanted to come to you guys and talk about the eclipse. If you've been watching all my videos, you know that the eclipse has its own energy, right? It's off. The energy is off. This is a lunar eclipse we're going into on July 4th. So it depends on your location. Some people will hit the high peak on the 5th. My location will be on the 4th Pacific Standard Time. So when the planets, depends on what astrology chart you're looking on. It's going to be moving from one zodiac sign to the other. Some of us is going to feel the energy, the strong effect of one zodiac sign versus the other. Okay, the one that the full moon will be on. I could hold this other laptop in my lap. I'm like, what am I thinking? So if I wanted to look at the one last month, well, let me just stay with this month. This month, July 2020, it's in Sagittarius today, Friday, July 3rd. It's in Sagittarius at 9:48 or 21:48. It's going to switch over from Sagittarius to Capricorn. So are you, the last moon, were you vibing with Cancer? Were you vibing with Gemini? So it all depends on your location, okay? And when I first started looking at astrology, I was so angry. I was so upset because I was like, I need more information. I need to know when it switches from one sign to the other. And I couldn't find the website. This was like 6 years ago. And I was doing astrology way before that, but really into it and talking about it online. And it's a whole different format than when you're talking to someone in person, but really wanted to know when that switch was and when was the high peak for my location where the energy of the moon is strongest. Now I've been saying from a tradition that I vibe with, because just from the alignment and the movement of the planet, if you're having a solar eclipse or a lunar eclipse, this will be a moon eclipse on July 3rd. July 4th and July 5th, depending on where your location is, in Capricorn, an earth sign Capricorn. It's going to make an impact on you, okay? Because, and I'm trying to bring up something else, because the energy is going to be the sun was out of alignment. So this lunar eclipse is going to be more of, in its off of its course, okay? So this energy is going to be a little bit more chaotic. So you don't want to pull in energy. You don't want to clear any crystals. Nothing, no energy work, but there is thought work that can be done. There is mindful work that can be done where you're sitting and being still, okay? And that's what you want to do. You don't want to do anything, especially if you're not someone that meditates a lot, right? Because when you don't meditate a lot, you're not going to be able to handle the energy of the day, okay? So the moon is moving into the earth's shadow, okay? So there's going to be that earth energy where we've been feeling a lot more tense from everything that's going on, but that's the shift. And a shift, a change sometimes is not relaxing. Sometimes it's a little bit crazy and then it gets better, right? So Can you handle your own life, the earth frequency, the change in the energy on the earth? Can you also handle the emotion that the moon represents? And then the moon also represents messages, right? So we have to be really mindful of how spiritual we are. And we can't just be, oh, let me be aware on the high moon days. And then I'm not aware on the everyday practice, right? For self and also for moon work, okay? So I already told you what the high peak is, and it's in Capricorn, right? So on this full moon eclipse, it is the third in the cycle. So this is a completion, right? So if you thought of the three of them as mind, body, and spirit, and this is what I'm going to talk about mostly on my yoga channel, then this is the spirit. The spirit has to get shift, right? Mind was awakened, right? The body, a lot of things happening with the body, right? And it's all happening, three of them simultaneously, it's happening all the time, but it's just more of a focus. The mind has opened up recently, right? Even more than the body. How does the body feel? You know, when you experience trauma or sadness or whatever you're going through, the anxiety, it's not just everyday anxiety of, which everyday anxiety is fine, but a more of a life and survival anxiety, right? And then we're going to go into the spirit. So now the spirit has to be awakened. And then this is where the biggest shift happened. Not to mention that on full moons, it represents completion of a cycle. So also truths are revealed at that time, right? So people have to be realistic with themselves and with others. That's never an easy step to do, okay? So knowing that Capricorn is a cardinal sign, okay? Some of us might be dealing with issues of that as well. Others will be dealing with that Saturn energy, right? Because Saturn is also in the 12th house for this full moon, along with Jupiter and Pluto. And the moon is also in that area. For my location, the moon is actually in the 11th house, okay? So the emotion of the moon is what we aspire to be this full moon. What do you aspire to be? What are your own personal goals? What are your goals for your life? So these are things we're taking note on. Our friends, our groups, our goal, our aspiration, everything that the 11th house has to deal with. How do you fit into that, and what changes do you need to make? And some of you have already made changes. I know in my personal life, the 11th house is strong. It's group. What is the group bringing to my life? What's your family bringing to your life? What's your friends bringing to your life, right? How does that affect you? And then what do you personally aspire to be, and what do you hope for your family or people that are close to you, and even the outside people like your associates and acquaintances and so on, and just people you see in general, right? But the people that are closest to you, this is your spirit. This is your spirit connection, your life cycle. When you come into your life, these people that are close to you are the people that you're supposed to learn lessons from, and they're supposed to learn from you. And we really have to stand up for ourselves and be better for ourselves and the people around us, right? It's relearning ancient teachings of honor, respect, duty, love. And the word love, someone was saying, gets thrown around so easily. But when you break down love, you have joy in that. You have trust and you have comfort. Like, you want to be comfortable in your dwelling. You want the people you love to be comfortable in that dwelling. You want joy, right? Right? I forgot the other word I mentioned because I'm just like pulling it in here. But what you want for yourself, you're going to want that for someone else that you care about, right? So what does Capricorn represent? It represents, the symbolism of it is a goat and a sea. with the tail and a goat, right? The sea goat, right? So it's that balance of water and earth, right? The goat being an earth, right? And the tail of it like a fish or a mermaid being of water. So those both elements need each other, the water and the earth, just like fire and air, right? So it produces that growth. And right now we have to grow, kind of like you plant your seed and you watch it grow. After the full moon, it's going to be the waning moon, right? And you think about things that grows beneath the earth, right? And you think of that darkness and how can we grow from our darkness in this upcoming waning moon? How can we grow from the things that we don't understand, the things that protect us? Darkness can be what protects you, right? You can use it to your advantage, both darkness and light. But you think of darkness, you can grow in that. You can see clearly in that if you're in the right location where you can see and others can't see you. You can grow from that, right? Very deep when you think about it, right? Capricorn is associated with the 10th house of career. What is being built off of you and what can you build for yourself, right? That's the Capricorn energy. That's what you really secretly need to think about. And how is that beneficial for you? What you know you're doing and what you don't know that is being done that will eventually affect you. Saturday. This is happening on Saturday in my location. Saturday is Saturn's day. Saturday in the 12th house. Saturn in the 12th house is about our fears. Let's talk about the planets. Saturn talks about our fears, what we're willing to fight for, and any kind of self-destructive behavior. So how can your strength not be destructive? How can you formulate that, right? Make it into your own little potion, right? A strong foundation, a strong core, and a strong head. Right? The mind, body, spirit connection, and really use that Saturn energy to overcome your fears to do something that is going to be good. It's a good day of journaling on the eclipse, right? So looking at our fears, our fight, right? And really look at channeling our behavior so it's not self-destructive. Because Saturn has that structure, but too much of it can be controlling and no one likes that, right? Right? So that's that Saturn in the 12th house energy. Let's go to Pluto. Okay. So Pluto, we know it has that psychic energy, but you think of Pluto as a planet, it sits back and it's watching everything happen. It's like you're at a party, you're at an event, and you're just observing. More like a party. Let's say that you're observing everyone, right? So Pluto is asking you to look into the depth of your own mind and others' mind, trying to understand your mind. Why do you think this way? Why do you believe this way? And then rethink. And then while you're trying to understand your own mind, it's also good and using your time management to understand other people's minds. Why do they think this way? Mm-hmm. And then doing this, I got to turn my volume off. Oh, doing this will help you to communicate better with others and understand why someone might think a certain way in your own personal relationship and just your life at large, right? So that's what Pluto is asking, right? And it's so funny because you think of something, say like Pluto, something smaller than a bigger planet, or it's just smaller, just think in size of anything in size, right? Well, you can think someone has a small mind, right? Or they're portraying to have a small mind. And this been like hitting my mind yesterday, the day before, and today. Well, for even longer than that. But today it was like boom, boom, boom. The person that angers you the most can help you change, can help you grow. The person that once you figure out that person really hates on me, you can use that to make you weak or you can use it to make you strong, right? When you confront it. But just imagine that you really tap into your own personal power and you realize that someone that's judging you, that's angry at you, that, and you don't deserve it, right? It's not like they're offering a helping hand, but they're just judging. You use that as your power. Now say that in another sense, someone maybe you don't know or someone that you do know personally, right? The person that angers you the most, you have to ask yourself, why does this person upset me so much? And then even if you completely hate this person, what if this person gives you more change and you have that fight to better yourself or to better your situation or better your outcome, better your daily life? You can be the best person ever, but you can be the kindest person ever, the best person ever, or the worst person ever. But there's a standard that needs to be met, right? And let's just say that you're the best person ever. You're the best that you can possibly be. You're kind, you're sweet, you're whatever. But you still need some form of improvement that only you can give yourself, right? And that's really going into the human psyche, your mind, to really figure out yourself and understand where another person's coming from. But going back to the sum of it, you have to make sure that you're okay. Because if you're not okay, then nothing else really is going to be substantial for you, right? So this Pluto energy is asking you to look at the things that is unconscious to you, to your unconscious mind, and then even writing it down and really understand it, right? So that you can express yourself, so that you have a better understanding, so that you feel confident in the actions, the things that you're doing. Okay, let's look at Jupiter. Jupiter is like, it gives you blessings, right? But you need Saturn first to get you in check, okay? And you need the right dose of Saturn. I think of Saturn as like spice. It has to be the right amount of spice so you can actually enjoy the meal and you don't feel like this is just pepper and tasting. Even if it's the most flavor pepper. Some pepper they make it just to be hot and that's crap. But like real pepper with a flavor, you can still enjoy it, but sometimes you just need a little bit, your level, where you can still enjoy the meal, right? So that's what Saturn is to me. Jupiter is like a fruit, right? It's not overly sweet. It's just right. And you're like perfect, right? Jupiter is that blessing. But the blessing in this third eclipse is the blessing that you can give yourself. You are your good luck, right? So what do we believe? You have to ask yourself, what do I believe? And let me pause. Some of you are going to vibe with Saturn more, Jupiter more, Pluto more, and even the moon. But whichever one you vibe with the most, you're still going to need Saturn first. Then you will need Pluto. And then Jupiter steps in because that's the blessing, right? So it would be really the moon first. I'll get to the moon last because that's our emotion. And what message is your emotion given to yourself, your soul, right? And what does it do to your outer body? How does your emotion affect your physical shape? So we'll get into that. But Pluto is your belief. What do I believe and why do I believe it? And how is this belief helping me? Right? And then having faith. Why do you have to have faith in this one particular thing? Why do you need to have faith? Do you really need to have faith? Right? But yeah, faith is good. My personal opinion, faith is good. But you can't rely on faith alone. And Saturn would have taught you that. The faith that you have to have is in yourself because it's already within you. Right? That's a spiritual understanding. Whatever the creator created you, you have it. You have to have faith in yourself. Your good fortune comes from your action. You are your good luck. But you're going to have that within you. Now, like I said on the moon, I didn't really make anything on the moon. And just to reiterate, Saturn, Jupiter, and Pluto is in the 12th house. The 12th house is your dreams. We didn't talk about the dreams. 12th house represents like, you know, Pisces, Pluto energy. Okay. So it's your dream, your spiritual dream, your spiritual life, right? Your spiritual life and having a strong spiritual belief is not going to weigh you down to anything. You are like the air and like the ether, where you know that you have enough awareness spiritually to know that there's something more than this, but you are not foolish enough to feel like you have all the answers, right? So this 12th house vibe is being in solitude and giving yourself that time to sit and meditate and to think, right? So that when someone comes to you with a club or this kind of association, maybe you can be a part of it, because you can make some kind of positive change, or you can learn something for some of you out there that's being invited into some kind of club, but you're not that club. You are yourself. So you have to have some form of discernment. So moving into the summer energy, having discernment is going to be really powerful. Can you evolve through everything that you're going through, your group activities and your solo activities? You have to transcend who you are. You have to be growing. And then while you're growing, there's a yin and yang of self-sabotage, what the 12th house also talks about. So how are you destroying yourself right now? And when you hit that high of, yeah, I'm vibing, everything is good. When you're getting compliments a lot, that's good. But don't forget your spiritual work, protecting your energy, all of these things, right? Because that's what's really key. And we have to remember not to self-sabotage ourselves. So adding all of that, taking notes on that, and then looking at what does Saturn say to you for your personal life experience right now? What does Jupiter say? What does Pluto say? And now coming to the moon. The moon was the old Mercury, the old messenger, right? The moon is very well connected to the earth and the pull of the earth. I was talking to a friend, and the energy, the frequency of the earth is a higher pitch with everything going on right now. When someone talks all fluffy, light worker talk of an awakening coming, you know, it's not going to be pretty. And what we're experiencing right now is not pretty, but it's an awakening. People are waking up, are realizing more, right? And moving in the waning moon that we're coming up to after this full moon into the new moon, we have to, the message for this last full moon eclipse, we are the full moon, we're the manifestation of everything that we are working for, no matter what moon cycle we're in, no matter what year it is, no matter what decade it is, we are our own manifestation. We are the full moon because we're either completing a lesson that we're going through, completing a work week, completing a lesson, completing a thought, completing some form of freaking experience, right? We completed it, or something was revealed to us and we found the answer. We got the answer. But with this last eclipse, we have to maintain our perseverance or persistence, right? So the energy of Capricorn is always being persistent, right? Always being persistent. Think of Capricorn work ethic, right? Always being persistent. And then going back to the energy of the day for Saturday, what I want to talk about is another meaning of Saturn is suspension, right? Meaning a halt or a pause or some form of a temporary prevention of something. Some of us will notice in our lives and in the big scheme, someone trying to prevent you from doing something. Maybe there's something you need to talk about or something that you need to do. They're going to make up an excuse to prevent something from happening, right? They're going to try and force their will to change what needs to be done. They're going to try to have an effect on something to not do what's needed to be done, some of us might notice that we're being asked to wait, right? Experience some kind of preventing of what needs to be done right now. So that's like the main thing that I wanted to focus on. But what the message is that look in your own life and see where someone might not be the most perfect person, right? Something may be off, but there's a gift within that person, right? So I'm going to look at it in different ways. Something might not be perfect about a person or a situation or something, but there's something there, right? There's a diamond waiting to be formed. So some of us will have that positive experience. Now, on the negative experience, someone that upsets you the most can be the person that brings about the best change rather than a smooth talker that keeps just like blowing air and then that's it and nothing gets done. So we really have to look at what things are and really keep our energy up, keep the spirit up so that we're not falling back into this kind of relaxed state of being. Right? So I love to look at these three eclipses as mind, body, and spirit, right? Or the start, the middle, and the end. It's like a whole body of something. And this experience is going to really bring us to our realization at this full moon. And just think of all the things in our lives right now that's being revealed. Everything is happening within 3 days of the full moon. Big things happen. The day of the full moon, a big thing will happen, right? So all of these reveal. Well, tomorrow is going to be the 4th. So everyone, I want you to enjoy that. All right. I hope that Juneteenth can celebrate it next year as, you know, fireworks and big band sound and kind of New Orleans vibe. I would love to do that, like a parade of big bands. And stuff like that, you know, celebration. So let me pull a card and three cards and just set the intention for the full moon. This is the emperor just fell out upside down. Okay. So full moon, July 4th, the high peak is at 9:44 PM Pacific time. Full moon in Capricorn, also a lunar eclipse. Lunar eclipse, really think about your emotions and the message of your emotions. What does that mean? And the foundation of Earth, our home. How do we care about our home? Why do we care about our home? Some of you will have to think about that. Why is home important to you? What's important to you? Your spirit. Right? It's a spiritual connection that everyone's going to be vibing under, right? The spirit is stronger than the mind and the body because that's just our physical experience right now in this life. Our spirit is old. Our spirit is oneness. It's like that one love vibration, right? So our spirit recognizes when things is out of balance. Send the intention to get a message for this full moon. 9 of Pentacles, the Fool, the Lovers. I feel that there'll be a prominent feminine energy. I feel that it'll be a new start. I feel that this energy will be positive. Yes, there's a lot of yellow. There's a lot of light. But also, it's not going to be a commitment. Okay? This will be a symbolism of a female energy coming in at the end of the year. And it's going to be a new start. But this new start isn't going to be a huge commitment. That's why I'm telling you guys that you have to remain persistent for your own personal goals and also for the energy shift in a positive, more balanced way for our Earth. Okay? Because the lover's energy isn't something that is everlasting, right? It's not something that is a concrete agreement. It's more of a temporary love affair lust. That's why I'm saying that someone that's a smooth talker, and that's fine. That's fine. Maybe we need a little change, but, and that person can be a good person, but do you want someone to make you feel good or actually to be the cure, right? So this feminine energy has worked hard to achieve everything that she has, if you know the meaning of the Nine of Pentacles. Very well educated and successful. Great. But the Fool is having a new start, but also the Fool is open to learn again, going back to zero, to refill the mind and to grow and to move up the levels of learning, knowledge, wisdom, everything. And that's good. But the lover is going to be a short-term thing. It's not something that's going to be forever. That's why for the energy for the end of the year is to keep persistent. Don't fall back asleep. Okay? So happy full moon in Capricorn. Really focus on the essence of Capricorn. The degree is 13 degrees, 37 minutes. So about 37 minutes to 40 minutes of really journaling and really thinking about the questions that I asked. You know, the questions I didn't really ask it because I'm kind of saving it also for my yoga, my meditation channel. But ask yourself, how can I be more in control of myself? Ask yourself, how can I be more organized and prepared? This is what came to me and I wrote down it. Ask yourself, how can I be more relentless for myself and others, right? Highest good. When I write stuff down, I don't finish the word. So that whole relentless energy is that persistent energy that we really have to hold on to that. So I know I said a lot. So you'll see what you vibe with, okay? And connect to that. Definitely click like so others can see this video. That's really important that you guys click like. And I hope that you enjoy this reading. Tomorrow I'll upload the video for, let me see. I'll upload the video for each zodiac sign reading. This is just an overall reading. This video is a little bit longer than I wanted to, but it's all good. All right, I'll see you guys next time. Peace.